It's almost impossible to imagine. It's like, you can't write this fucking shit.
Enjoy the waves.
Enjoy the waves.
Think it changed you?
Wait, I gotta hear that again. I had a fortune in my pocket. This is life's a beach.
Enjoy the waves.
Do you think it changed you?
Yes, you're coming down for me.
James Michael says the whole experience has given him new purpose.
These were actually the pants that I'd planned on wearing on the cruise, but never got to. And I put them on this morning, and I reached in the pocket, and there was something. There's a fortune, and it says, life's a beach, enjoy the waves.
I had another one in my other pocket that said, osh, gosh, my gosh.
Think it changed you?
Yes, definitely. It opened my eyes. I take things for granted, I reckon, or a lot of people do.
Do you think you'll go on a cruise ship again?
Fuck no!
Yeah, I'll go next week.
Yeah, I will. Yeah, I ain't gonna let it discourage me that much.
I'm
they
a
got
man.
Air guitar.
That's right. I'll stay inside. I'm gonna win another competition. I'll win every fucking competition.
I might not get within 10 foot of the rails, but
I'll make sure I got an indoor cabin.
Be open to going on another cruise because I really didn't get to go on this one.
My donkey ass fell over.
That was the topper of the whole story at the end. He's got to top it with, I reached it in my pocket, and there it was. Life's a beach. Ride the waves.
Wow.
Guess what? I did.
With just my socks.
Oh, God, I'm sorry. That was too much.
That was a good one.
How great is that? That is my favorite. I think from now on, you have to tell us, where did this trash smell like? Alabama, Mississippi, Florida, or 315?
Is that it? Because I mean, we can't surpass that story.
No, you can't. Well, we'll stop. But first, if you fall overboard, you're probably going to work up quite an appetite. When you dry yourself off, I suggest you get to Jimmy Z's Plates and Shakes in Brockport. This segment brought to you by Jimmy Z's Plates and Shakes. Get a Jimmy Z's gift card for your loved one. Check it out at platesandshakes.com.
Yeah. Billified, the Bill Moran Podcast.
Foodie, I say, is a, I don't want to say gambling fishy. I don't want to make you look like a degenerate.
Yeah, I kind of am.
But we've got a Thursday night football game.
Yeah.
And then a pretty big weekend with the Jets coming to Buffalo for 1 o'clock on Sunday. So if you're betting tomorrow, or if you're betting tonight, Thursday night, who do you like?
Well, let's play a little closest to the pin.
Closest to the pin.
Oh, boy.
Okay, I like this.
You like it?
He brought his own game.
I do like this.
All right, so there's been about 200 NFL games so far this year.
Okay.
You know about the spread, you know, favorites, underdogs.
Yep.
How many games has the spread mattered in that 200?
I think a lot. In out of the 200, I'm going to say, I want to say in 125 games. That seems very high, actually. I'm holding on. I'm going to say, you're saying it only counted in 5 games or 50?
50. Okay. 50 games?
50 games, says Angie.
50.
32 games.
I was going to say 75. That's going to be my final answer.
32 games. So favorite wins, they cover the spread.
More times than not. So then if you're betting,
but
how about all these games? I feel like there's been so many games that have gone into overtime this season, that have gone into, right? Yeah, that they were
the
close.
Underdog wins.
Yeah.
Then the underdog win.
Okay.
Right.
But that's only been 30. It's 32 mattered 30 times.
It's mattered. And most of the time it's the Chiefs. And about, I would say, 4 to 5 times, it's a half a point, right? So if you're on the right side of the line, you get the line early in the DraftKings app or whatever app you're using,
right?
You could actually win that game. So what I'm saying is, if you like an underdog, just bet the money line.
Bet the money line.
Just go for it.
Yeah.
You know, because you're going to make out better.
Okay.
That's actually
really smart. You know, when you look,
Numbers,
I wouldn't have thought, God, I would have thought that it would have mattered more.
What would, I'm sorry. See, I'm trying to follow
the spread.
The spread would have mattered more.
Yeah, because all you're doing is like, if you go into overtime and the spread's 4 or it's 5, and somebody wins by a field goal, well, the losing team covered.
Right.
So if you bet them, then they covered. I feel like there's been a lot more games, but
99 times the underdogs covered.
Yeah. Okay.
You always when I'm you know, watching you or with you and on Sunday or Monday or whatever, and football's on, you always talk about the money line now. I never hear
it's the new philosophy.
It's the new philosophy. He's gone away from the old, you know, they've covered the spread. Right. It used to be a lot of covering the spread, and now it's the money line.
So take the Dallas game this weekend. It's plus 17.
Yeah.
Oh, they blew them out of the water.
You're not taking the, you know, I'm not taking the money line on that game.
No.
That's just, you know.
It seems ridiculous because, because Dallas may win, but they may win by a touchdown. So that means the teams,
yeah.
Then it would matter.
That's what I'm saying. Right. It feels like it'd be more than 32 games.
You would think.
It feels that way.
Yeah.
That's how dumb I am.
So tonight we got the Rams Raiders.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
I think the Rams are a mess right now.
They're done.
They just signed.
Is Baker Mayfield going to start? There was talk that Baker Mayfield may start.
There's talk.
Their season's over. They're just evaluating for next year. I hear Stafford's talking about retirement.
Well, he's pretty messed up.
Yeah, I thought the retirement was like
issue.
Yeah.
You know, the Raiders, they've been playing better of late. They won the last three.
I wonder if next year they get a guy named Brady.
Maybe.
If McDaniel stays as the coach, I wonder if he does end up there. I really do. It was one of the teams. I keep going, where's he going next year? I don't think he's going to the booth, and if he does, I think he's going to suck.
He's going to suck.
Devontae Adams has exploded over the last three games.
Too. Yeah.
Like, I think the last game,
you know, the
crazy stat was he caught 8 balls. They were all for first downs.
Wow. So you're saying take the Raiders.
I'm taking the Raiders.
Yeah. Take the Raiders. Don't take the money. Yeah, take the Raiders. Okay.
Minus 6.
Okay.
No money line on
that one. All right.
All right, you want to talk Bills?
Yeah, Bills-Jets.
How about Sunday. My guy, Mike White?
I know. I don't know what to think of Mike White.
5th round pick.
Kind of like him because he just seems like he's just that guy. He's kind of like, yeah, hey man, that's what I do.
Right.
Is kind of thing.
They've rallied around Mike White.
Yeah.
Now they lost last week. They should have won. Minnesota. I watch a lot of Jets games.
Yeah. I worry with Buffalo being down Micah and being down now Von Miller. I think Matt Milano's out for this game.
The Jets sacked Josh 5 times.
Yeah,
the first time.
That wasn't pretty.
That's the game he hurt his elbow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, last whatever.
Yep.
Right? Revenge game for the Bills.
Wait. When he hurt his elbow.
Yeah.
The Jets game?
Yeah.
Okay. I was thinking Thanksgiving.
No.
Yeah. Hey, the men are talking. Just.
I'm sorry. Oh, don't me.
I am kidding. It was a joke.
I know.
The line's 9.
Okay.
Where are you going?
I'll say Buffalo. I don't know if I like the 9. I really don't know. It doesn't feel good with all those guys out, especially on defense.
I do think they're going to win.
Yeah, I do too.
I think it's going to be 24-17.
Yeah.
Maybe 23.
Yeah. I like that score, and I like Buffalo winning, but I don't know that they cover.
The spread is.
So what do you just bet them straight up?
Too close.
Just bet the Bills.
You would take the Jets.
Oh, Jets to cover.
Or you would last game, you took Jets money line.
Money line.
It
then
was
you win.
Plus.
So was it? What did you say?
490 last. Yeah. So you would, $100. You're winning $490.
$90, yeah.
I don't bet that much.
I'll take that cash.
You'll say of into a microphone.
No, I don't.
Okay. All right.
Per game.
What? Who's Sunday night?
Oh, I don't.
Okay. Who else you got?
I got Kansas City and Denver.
Okay. Oh, come on. It's done. Denver's done.
They're toast, right?
Yeah.
Interesting stat.
Stop.
Denver's over under.
Yeah.
1-11. They've went over the total one time all year.
They went over the total one time all year.
One time. Every other game's been under.
Under, because you get the over-under.
Right.
So you're saying bet the over.
No.
Don't.
Bet the under.
Under.
Yeah. Wait.
That's
give me that again.
That's their consistency.
They've only gone over once. Denver has.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so bet the under.
Bet the under.
Okay.
They're a mess.
Gotcha, gotcha. Yeah, they are
Russell
a mess.
Wilson's a mess.
Well, now the big thing becomes, is it Russell Wilson or is it Nathaniel Hackett? Nathaniel Hackett, who was the offensive coordinator at one point for the Buffalo Bills.
And Syracuse,
because he came with Doug Marrone, but had great success in Green Bay. I mean, was...
As the OC.
Yeah. People really spoke highly and had a decent relationship with Aaron Rodgers, but he just seems lost, man. That guy, this has got to be a one and done. There's new owners out there. Do you think the Walton family that's going to now is part of Walmart and owns the Denver Broncos is going to sit for this? No.
No, he's gone.
Mm-hmm. You know what he's going to be saying soon? Welcome to Walmart. No, I don't know.
All right, I got one more.
All right, one more.
It's college.
Okay.
You know what this weekend is? Army-Navy.
The Army-Navy, big one.
Oh, big game.
Yeah, that was always big.
They're down by you, Army, right?
Yeah, they were down West Point, right?
So you follow Army?
I did as a kid a little bit, yeah. Not a lot. We used to go to West Point every once in a while.
More of a Navy guy.
I always thought the... I was always kind of intrigued by the... there were chicks that liked the Navy uniform is what she told me, so I was with... When I was like 14, 15.
I don't know. My dad was in the Navy.
Okay.
I've been to the game.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, really?
Yeah. Where's the game this year?
Philly.
Okay. Why do I think Navy's got this one?
All right. We're going to play another closest to the pick.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
It has to do with the over and under, right?
Okay.
So the over under. How many years in a row has the Army-Navy game gone under the total?
How many years in a row has it gone under the total? Oh, I don't know. It's either going to be something ridiculously high or something ridiculously low. Like, it could be something like 25 years, or it could be three.
I was going there first, but I'm going five.
15 years.
Damn!
15 years in a row?
I told you it was going to be like...
Wow.
Yeah. These are really disciplined.
Yeah. If you took your $10, right, you bet $10 the first year, then you kept that $10 and you let it ride every year. You just keep betting that same amount.
Yeah.
You'd have $100,000.
Look at this.
This is why I hang on to him.
Yeah. Yeah, for all the things he doesn't have and wishes he did.
Sure.
Hey, you know, had I done that, I'd have $100,000.
I just don't do it.
Yes, that's what it is. I always love those. Hey, man, you know, if you did this, you'd have this. Why didn't you?
Maybe the sea creatures wouldn't get you. Just before we get done.
Yep.
Under in all service academy games, so that's Air Force, Army, Navy, right, when they play each other, 43-9-1 in games between the service academies in the last, I think, since 1995. So just bet the under blindly and you're fine.
Yeah.
Oh. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
And then for everybody listening, just take all those bets and bet the opposite and you'll be a winner.
I kind of like it, Kevin. I think that's good advice. We have to have you back as we get into the playoffs and everything. Mm-hmm.
There we go.
Turn it up.
That's right. I got my sea creature shirt, and I'm ready to go. That'll be it.
It's satin.
It is. I think that guy needs a satin jacket, a satin sash, or something to walk around town.
Just like the Tiger King.
Sea creatures didn't eat me.
I bet you. Oh, yeah. Does he have
a satin jacket?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did. Does this guy have a mullet, too?
Oh,
he does not.
So.
He did not have a mullet.
Maybe he cut his hair.
Sea creatures ate it. That's actually, he ate it to survive.
Yes.
That and bamboo, and he survived.
Did he have all his teeth?
Yeah, he did. Uh-huh. And a fourth grade education. We will see you tomorrow.